Hi, I'm Bill Lampton, the Biz Communication Guy, talking to you today from a very windy Gainesville, Georgia. Thankful that we don't have the snow that has blanketed and practically crippled the northeastern part of the United States. We have a wind chill here today that would wake anybody up. And I can tell you, when I've taken the dog for a couple of walks, that has been exceptionally brisk. Today, I'm thinking about people who have asked me when I'm being considered as their business consultant for a seminar or a series of seminars. Sometimes they will look at a proposed agenda and they ask me, why is it you have listening on here? We thought your bailiwick was teaching people how to talk, how to get messages across. Well, yes, I do identify myself as a speech coach, but at the same time, as many excellent presenters as we need, we also need people who receive messages quite well. I was thinking then, as I realized how much I emphasize listening, I was thinking of five situations where listeners are going to become winners, five business situations. Number one would be if you are interviewing for a job. One of the tendencies job applicants have is to write out either an outline or a sort of a manuscript of what they want to say. They rehearse it. Maybe they do it with video. Maybe they watch the video again. Possibly they even have an interview coach. They're determined that when they go into the interview, they want to give this spiel verbatim, get every point across. And yet, much as we think that would be a winning situation, it's not. It's a turnoff. Interviewers are looking for someone who can react spontaneously, instantaneously, not anything planned or canned, just react, so that when the applicant is asked some questions, the applicant demonstrates that he or she has heard the question and they respond to it specifically. They don't pull a political trick and switch to something else which they're already scripted on their own doing, scripted to say. Next time you are going to be interviewed for a job, be sure that you are responsive, that you are in the moment, that you are truly having a live conversation which involves active listening on your part. A second situation, sales. We have gone way past the time when a salesperson had a standard pitch which he or she used in every sales setting, whether it was to an individual or to a group, and didn't particularly care what the feedback was. For a good number of years now, we've had the phrase consultative selling. Consultative selling means that if I'm trying to sell you something, I listen for what your needs are. What are your concerns? What are your problems? The more I can listen to them, catch them, understand them, and then have solutions for them, the more likely I am to be the person whose product or services you want to have. And then a third place where in the business world listening is so important is when you are a supervisor, a manager, a CEO. We've heard the expression from a lot of leaders, well, I have an open door policy. You can see me at any time. I'm ready to talk with you about your concerns. But what happens when the employee goes in there? Do they get full attention? Or does this supervisor take phone calls or send text messages or look at his or her calendar? Full listening, attentive listening, is what's needed, and even the highest level of listening, what Stephen Covey called empathetic listening. And then, as well, customer service. Good customer service requires serious listening. If we analyze how we can satisfy the complaints, the grievances, the disturbance of many unsatisfied customers, one of the keys is being attentive and receptive. If we show them that we have heard their complaint, that we understand why they're making it, that we're sorry that they have been troubled, we're a long way toward winning back their allegiance. And then one more spot I will mention where listening is key is in networking. We've all been to events where it's clear that several people there have one goal, and that is to corner as many of the participants as they can, give them the business card, talk to them about what they do, not wait around for a response, but move along to the next supposed prospect. Really, these people are not conversationalists. They're scorekeepers. At the end of the evening, if they've had 15 to 20 conversations where they've given out their business card, they've talked about what they can offer, they think it's a success. But it probably is not. So in each of these situations that I've mentioned, in sales, customer service, interviewing for a job, managing, and networking, be a great listener. And when you are a great listener, you will have super results. Thank you very much for listening to this Facebook Live today. I invite you to visit my website where you'll find more about my services. Biz Communication, that's B-I-Z, is my website, bizcommunicationguy.com. I also will welcome your phone calls so we can talk about how I can assist you with your biz communication. 678-316-4300. And now I can't expect you to listen longer, so I'm going to push that old Facebook Live finish button and look forward to the next time that I get to visit with you this way. Thanks again. I'm Bill Lampton.